Welcome back to Boiler Bytes. Have you ever wondered what an unfettered rainforest sounds like? Or maybe you're curious about the sounds of the shifting coastal tides of Alaska. The world's ecosystems are constantly changing, and sound is a major part of every ecosystem on Earth. A group at Purdue, led by Professor Bryan Pijanowski, has been recording soundscapes from around the world in order to archive and study the ever-changing sounds of our planet. Our next segment will give you a look at, and a listen, to what is happening at the Center for Global Soundscapes.
A soundscape is a collection of all sounds that occur at a place. And what we do is we try to identify three different kinds of sounds based upon their sources.
It can be biological, geophysical, or from anthropology sources, so it's a sound composition. And it depends of the source of the sounds, but as well the transmission of the sounds from the emission to you. You are the receiver of the sounds.
Biological organisms need to produce sounds for a variety of reasons. And so nature in all of its splendor and beauty produces sounds that are phenomenally complex. And we use those sounds as an ecologist to understand natural systems. So those are the biological sounds. And then there's the geophysical. This is the wind, the water, the thunder, the avalanches, even the rumbling of the ground. And then the third source of sounds are the sounds that we make, humans. There have been people talking about soundscapes since about the 1960s, and most of them are in the fields of humanities, the fields of music. So it really wasn't until probably the late 1990s that ecologists began to think about using sound in more creative ways other than just, say, putting a microphone out and recording a bird song. The field of soundscape ecology is virtually brand new. 2011 was really the big splash. There was a small group of us that put together these ideas in a paper, and we've got maybe 30 or 40 people around the world that have kind of adopted this new paradigm of going out and recording everything that we hear and analyzing everything that we hear.
We have like the laboratory, Center for Global Soundscapes. The objectives of the center is to increase the knowledge about soundscape first and value ecosystems and soundscapes of the ecosystems to be able to conserve the soundscape of the ecosystems.
We place microphones out in the wild and then collect sounds for long periods of time.
When we arrive on an area, we analyze the area, choose location, and put this recorder, and we let them run as long as we are in the field.
So what we have are these what's called passive automated recorders. There are boxes with two microphones sitting off the side, about the same spacing as our ears. So we have a really good, when we record it, you put your headphones on, it seems like you're just there. It's really kind of cool. And inside that recorder is a power supply, so you got batteries, and then chips that are very similar to the chips we use in our cell phones, and then a programmable interface where we can tell it to start and stop and what all the parameters are.
It's really easy. You can just attach the box on a tree trunk, and then you close the box and you let it run for as long as you want.
We place these strategically across the landscape in ways that help us to understand the diversity of the sounds that occur there, and then how it's related to the diversity of the habitat.
You save all this data on the computer, so you need a lot of space. We have a big server here in Purdue to do that.
What we're generating truly is big data. I mean, we can go toe-to-toe with the physicists and the genomics folks that are generating massive amounts of data. So Purdue is just ripe. We have the cyber infrastructure to be able to do that kind of work. I can move terabytes of data around on this campus without worrying about it. Purdue is a perfect place to do this kind of work for a variety of reasons. It does fit the STEM model. Science, technology, engineering, and math, we do it all.
What is interesting with Soundscape is it's in the middle of a lot of domain of research.
We're just so interdisciplinary. I have ecologists, social scientists, engineers, and musicians, and we're all working together to kind of study soundscapes from all of our disciplinary perspectives. I want to see us build a global library of soundscapes where scientists can share and begin to really fully appreciate all the diversity of sounds that we have on this planet. We've got a huge citizen science effort that's called Record the Earth. So every Earth Day, we try to get people to whip out their cell phones, download our app, and record their soundscape, upload it to our server, and listen and share. We have Just Listen IMAX movie that will be coming out sometime next year. And what we're gonna do is we're gonna have kids from grades 5 through 7 file into an IMAX movie theater and just get blasted by global soundscapes from all over the place. I hope to inspire kids to go into STEM and to really care more about nature and turn their ears back on.
If you want to listen to more Global Soundscapes or find out how you can get involved with the center, go online and check out globalsoundscapes.org. That wraps up another Boiler Bytes. Be sure to check us out online at boilerbytes.com. We'll see you next time.